Good evening. My name is Glenn Miles. I am the senior minister here at First Community Church, and we are thrilled to welcome you on this evening to this amazing evening of music and celebration of this beautiful new instrument. We want you to know a couple of things about our church before we begin. Number one, we'd like you to know that all are welcome, and not only that, all are accepted in this congregation. No matter who you are or where you're from, you are welcome and accepted as you are here. Secondly, we would like you to know that the worship and arts have been an important part of our ministry since the founding of our church. Yes, the spoken word matters in this congregation, but it is the music, more often than not, that fills the soul, that moves the heart, that opens the mind, and sends us out into the community, out into the world, to serve our neighbors near and far. Tonight, we are thrilled to present the Klais Organ Dedication Recital. This is indeed a dream come true, one that began many, many decades ago. There have been stops and starts and seemingly lost dreams, even dealing with a pandemic that got in our way. But tonight, we are seeing that indeed, dreams do come true. And so we are overjoyed on this evening to welcome the Professor Dr. Winfried Bönig, the senior organist for the Cologne Cathedral for over 20 years. He is known around the world for his brilliant musicianship. Would you please join me in welcoming Professor Bönig to the chancel?
Good evening. I was asked to tell you some words about the pieces I will play in that program. I deeply hope that my organ playing is better than my English. I hope it for you and for me. Yeah. So I try my best. First, I have to say I'm honored to be invited to be here to see this fantastic room, the acoustic, this fantastic instrument. When I came here yesterday and started, it needed only a few minutes to be electrified about this fantastic instrument, about its colors and the possibilities. So, and I had already before the concert started, I had some wonderful hours here in that church. The first piece, Charles Tournemire, is a very solemn entrance, and it's hardly believable that it's an improvisation. It looks like a composition, which hard work over weeks and a construction, but it's not like that. It's improvised in the moment, and Charles Tournemire, I think never he had the idea that Maurice Durufle could write down this improvisation from a tape which was made by a French broadcast society. And maybe if we would ask him, he would never like to have it done like that, because improvisation is done for the moment. But this piece is so excellent and so wonderful, I think it's worth, and I hope you have the same impression. Following piece, am I too loud? The following piece, Embrace of Fire, I played for long years already. When it happened that Naci Hakim made a second edition and he dedicated it to me, which made me very proud because I think this is one of his best compositions. And I like very much the idea about these three movements. It is a view, actually, these are three movements, three sentences out of the Bible, and they're giving three different images of God. The first is, come unto me, all who labor and are heavy laden. And you can hear, the music is like a painting, you can hear this heavy laden people walking and really suffering. And in the end of this movement, this sentence, this part, come to me. And these soft colors, they show that this heavy laden is taken away. The second movement, let the fire which I have kindled on earth consume them. It's the most furious piece of music in that program, I think. It shows the angry God punishing, and the music is like that, and it's an opportunity to show many of the trumpets and the tubas of that organs, and the music will, in a friendly way, of course, but it will attack you and will show you this angry image of God. And the last one, they who eat of my flesh and drink of my blood abide in me and I in them. This is a very intimate sentence, a very intimate idea, and such is the music, showing very soft colors again in that organ and the complete opposite of the second movement. Sometimes music can be like a preach, and I think this was something like that. It's telling so much about what the Bible is talking about. The next piece is one of my most favorites. Do you know this game? Maybe you played it. You have to go to a lonely island for the rest of your life, and you have only maybe 5 or 10 pieces of music to take with you. Which music would you take? Which pieces? I think this is it's a funny game, and it's if you're sitting in a car for a long time or in train or somewhere, you can play it. And my list, I have a list, and it is changing all the time, but one piece is always on that list. It is the following. It is this Chaconne by Johann Sebastian Bach. It's written only for violin. It is almost 15 minutes long, and he puts such an intensity and such a power in that piece, and he didn't compose it for orchestra or for at least for an instrument who can play a lot of chords. Now he composed it for violin, so maybe he made for himself this order to try to put as much as possible in one of the smallest instruments. And how much power and intensity is in that piece, it is shown if you transcribe this piece to other instruments. And it is transcribed to whatever you can imagine, for guitar, for piano, for different ensembles, for string quartet, or for big orchestra. There are a few transcriptions. And it's always the same music, and it always stays with all this power and all this quality. It's an incredible piece. Chaconne means actually variation. It's four bars, a very, very short subject or theme at the beginning, and many, many, many variations, and Bach shows his creativity in an incredible way. I hope you enjoy this piece as I do. I do my best. Thank you. During my playing, I thought I should not play you in advance. It's my most favorite. You could fail to be obliged to like it also. So please feel free to dislike it or to hate it, whatever. So. I forgot before to have a few words about Wilhelm Mittelschulte. He is in the program written as a transcriber of this piece from violin to organ. I am a German organist playing in the United States at the moment, and the same was Wilhelm Mittelschulte. He is a German, born in Germany, and he studied in Germany, and he came in the beginning of 20th century. He came to USA, and he became one of the most famous organists here in that country. One of his students became still more famous. His student was Virgil Fox. And so he founded a big tradition of American organ playing. The next piece I think most of you will know, Samuel Barber's Adagio, American composer. This was the reason I put it in the program, but not only, I tried to find pieces to introduce the organ to you, the new organ, and this piece is excellent for showing the very warm foundation stops of that organ. You can compare it with the strings in a big orchestra, and this organ has really a lot of them, and so it's like to have a big orchestra with a lot of violins and violas and cellos and so on. And so this piece can show these colors excellently. Someday I heard somebody saying this Adagio is the most sad piece of classical music. I completely do not agree. For me, this is the most peaceful piece, one of the most peaceful, let's say. Time is not important in that piece. It's very, very slow. And if you are nervous or you have to go, so don't listen to that piece. Actually, I would like to recommend you to listen to that piece with closed eyes, just to be in another world, like that piece can lead you to another world. So I hope it does. the last three pieces by Louis Vierne. He was organist in one of the most famous, maybe the most famous church in the world, Notre Dame in Paris. A long tradition of organists of centuries, which were famous for their music. He composed a collection of pieces, pièce de fantaisie, piece of fantasy, and he was very creative in finding the titles and finding the moods and finding the music to turn these moods into music. It's a very, very special music, and I like it very much, and it's fitting perfectly to that organ, as you may hear. I should not say in advance. The first is Hymne au Soleil, Hymne to the Sun. For me, it's always moving to think it's a very bright piece and the shining music, like the sun is shining, but Louis Vierne was blind. So actually he is telling about something he never saw himself. And this, for me, it's always moving because it shows how you can manage a disease or a handicap you have, who can somebody like him write such a solemn piece. The second one is Nayad. Nayad are, now I'm missing the English words, maybe you know this from the Greek mythology, so they are like girls, between girls and animals, they are swimming in the water, up and down, and the music is the same. And Le Cloche de Hinckley, it's the bells of the church in Hinckley. I like because it's the English way of the bells they are not as I am used as a German. This is not a single bells, but many of them together, and the piece is increasing more and more to a very solemn sound of bells. Before I close, I want to say something because for me it's so special. I know that he doesn't like it, but my assistant who helped me with this Bach piece, he voiced this organ, so he created all these colors, and I want just to say thank you because it's a very for me, it's easy. I just switch on and I have the color. But when the voice starts, nothing is in the room and he has to create it. And I'm very happy about that. And I hope you are happy for the future with this instrument.
Thank you.